guys, welcome back to another episode of Spin Weekly. My name is Grace Shalom Hopkins, and that introduction was backwards. So last time we spoke, I was telling you a little bit about my situation, why we're doing these informal videos, and the outpour of love has been insane. I'm so glad that I'm surrounded by amazing people who understand motherhood and poop on rainbow technology and all of the complications that go into running a business and a YouTube channel. You guys are amazing. I had so much anxiety about everything poop on rainbow related. On the flu front, we are getting better. Today in Hawaii, we were woken up by a false alarm missile warning. We all got the emergency services text, and they go, and it's like, the ballistic missile is headed towards Hawaii, this is not a drill. And so, that was terrifying. But it turns out it was a human error, so no ballistic missile. That's fun. Needless to say, we've had an exciting morning. And it really put into context some of my worries. Like, you know, my technology issue could be something like accidentally hitting this is not a drill and warning an entire state into, you know, hysteria, and not that my videos can't upload. So, anyway, that's not the point of this video. The point of this video is how to choose a spinning wheel, and I'll be redoing this with my more professional equipment in the future, but as kind of a dry run, this is a question I get asked all the time. How do you choose a spinning wheel? So I thought I would sit down and have a little powwow about it. There are kind of two major considerations, potentially four, two main and then four like secondary. So the first one is, what kind of yarn are you going to be spinning? Are you going to be spinning thick too thin, or more thin, or more thick? That's going to play huge into the kind of ratios and orifice you want. If you want more of a thin style wheel, you're going to want something with really high ratio, and the orifice size doesn't really matter. Also, you probably won't need to worry too much about getting oversized or jumbo bobbins, because unless you want to spend like bazillions and bazillions of yards, a lace weight isn't going to fill up a big pocket. You know, that's not going to be a problem. So, that being said, if you are looking for something that's more bulky, you're going to want a larger bobbin and a either larger orifice or a non-standard orifice like a hook. I'm a big fan of hooks in general. I think they're the most versatile, and if you can go for a hook or one of those little like loops, I guess, that is definitely my recommendation. If you ever have that option, go for that. You also are going to want something that has the ability to do a lower ratio. So most wheels hit in the middle. So if you really want lace weight, you're going to need higher. And if you really want bulky, you're going to need lower. So keep that in mind. And most companies are totally cool with customer service. Just give them a call and be like, this is the kind of yarn I'm spinning. Is this ratio appropriate for me? Spoiler alert, I generally have to do that. I only have kind of a loose knowledge on ratios, and that's something that I'm learning as I go. So now we're up close and personal. My arm got tired. Anyway, so the next thing you're gonna wanna think about is the give or take. And I'm gonna credit Ashley Martineau for coming up with this particular way of phrasing it. Some wheels pull, those are takers. And some wheels you kind of have to shove the yarn into the orifice, those are givers, yeah. So you give it or you take it, yeah. Does that make sense? Did I say that right? I think you know what I'm trying to say. Anyhow, I am a huge taker. I want the wheel to take from me. If I don't have that counter pressure, it messes up my spinning. And I have spun on wheels that I kind of have to feed the yarn into, and drives me nuts. I can never get a good yarn on them. So if at all possible, test drive and see which one you prefer, because usually it's like immediate, this one or that one. And people have really strong opinions on them. It's like menstrual products, you either. You really have strong feelings. I think most wheels are takers, but if you're a giver, you're going to want to keep an eye out for that. The other two considerations are price and portability. So price point, that's pretty self-explanatory, and portability also is pretty self-explanatory. If you need something that's portable, you're going to want to look for something that's easy to take apart or small. So all of that being said, I know I didn't mention specific brands. I did that on purpose because there's lots of different people. So I'm going to name a few and link them in the description, and you can do some of your own research. So there's Ashford. They make a Country Spinner 1, or I guess it's 2 now, and that's a good, like, bulky yarn wheel. They also make, I believe it's a Traveler and a Sidekick? No, Sidekick is Sachet. I never pronounced them right. that's why I'm linking them in comments down below, because some of these names are hard for me to pronounce. That's a traveling wheel. Most companies will do a bulky, a thin, and a traveling. So I'm going to try and break it down that way. But some of the more designer brands that are small, like Blue Bonnet or Babe or... what is that one that I'm thinking of? There's one that's made out of aluminum, and it's very much modeled after the old cars from the 50s. They only have one model. So yeah, I'll link down below. I really think this is very personal. I can't just say, hey, I recommend this one. There are different features for each one that are beneficial, and you are going to be drawn to which ones you want based on the criteria that I just shared. but just like a quick run through of my wheel journey, and I'm gonna do a more in-depth video of this for my Patreon people. So if you're a Patreon person, the video that is today is my wheel journey. And if you're not a Patreon person, you can find the links down below with all of that good information, because as you know, all of these videos are brought to you by our Patreon family. So I started off with a Blackfoot style spindle, which was really a crochet hook, and then I moved to a Babe pinky wheel and had a mini crisis because I thought I couldn't spin on a wheel and my career as a fiber artist was over, and poop on rainbows. It was definitely a poop on rainbows moment. I figured it out though. And then eventually I moved to a Country Spinner 1, and that was the first wheel that I really had a relationship with. It's a really beautiful wheel. Highly recommend. And it was big and sexy and Cadillac-y. I really liked that wheel. Then I moved to a Louette S15. No, that's the one that you see in my videos. And I really like that one. However, I do think it's pretty limited as far as the type of spinning. It's pretty much a middle ground. You can't get too fat or too skinny. It's just very much a middle wheel. Very basic. It's kind of like, I don't know, the Amish of the wheel. It's sturdy, good quality, well made, does what it does well, and that's it. And then my husband surprised me at Christmas with a Spinalution pinky wheel, and I am just beginning to explore, but there's so many cool little features on that wheel. So as far as cool feature goes, the Country Spinner 1 and the Spinalution are my favorites. I think they are the highlights of my fiber career. I think the Spinalution is definitely more versatile and has a lot more little features that make your life really easy, like the magnetic orifice, the magnetic bobbins. the way that they do the leader thread catch is super smart. You don't have to do stupid knots anymore. That's a big complaint I have with the Luet bobbin, is this stupid freaking leader threads driving knots and changing bobbins. That's why I became an expert on the Zinder pole ball. Oh, because changing bobbins make me want to hurt myself. Poop on rainbows. No poop on rainbows. Changing bobbins with the spinolution so far. So, those are my quickie thoughts on choosing a spinning wheel and my personal wheel journey. And if you have any thoughts or comments, wheel companies you really like, wheels you didn't like, any thoughts around choosing or owning a spinning wheel, I would love to know. I'm kind of putting together a like a wheel directory on my Patreon, so if you want a chance to kind of lend your voice there, now is your moment to speak. So I will see you next time. If you liked this video, hit the like button. If you want to catch up on all of the shenanigans, which are especially shenanigan-y recently, hit the subscribe button. And I will see you next time. Bye!